Hello aviation enthusiasts, welcome back to our channel. Today we have an exciting topic to delve into, the captivating story of Monarch Airlines McDonnell Douglas DC-10-30, registered as Golf-Delta Mike Charlie Alpha. Join me as we journey through the history, features, and significance of this iconic aircraft. Let's start by taking a look at the airline itself. Monarch Airlines, a British charter and scheduled airline, had a rich history spanning several decades. It was founded in 1967 and quickly established itself as a prominent player in the airline and holiday travel industry. Now let's shift our focus to the star of our show, McDonnell Douglas DC-10-30. This wide-body trijet was a true workhorse, known for its distinctive three-engine setup of General Electric CF6 engines, with each engine producing up to 51,000 pounds force, or 226 kilonewtons, an impressive range of 5,200 nautical miles, or 9,600 kilometers. Monarch Airlines acquired only one DC-10-30 into its fleet, with Delta Mike Charlie Alpha being that one aircraft. Let's step inside this airliner and explore its cabin features. The DC-10-30 was known for its spacious interiors, with seating up to 380 passengers in a single class layout, offering various classes to cater to different passenger needs depending on the airline. From comfortable seating to in-flight entertainment, this aircraft provided a memorable flying experience. Initially, this DC-10 was acquired by Zambia Airways on July 30th of 1984. While there, it was painted in a very colorful cheat line along the windows and with a green tail, with the company logo emblazoned in gold. While with Zambia Airlines, this aircraft was registered as November 30160 Zulu and was named Nkwazi, which translates to English from the Zulu language as I know. Unfortunately, in 1995, facing financial pressures after the Gulf War raised fuel prices and forced the termination of some routes, the airline was forced to liquidate and go out of business. It was at this time that this aircraft was put into storage at the Greensboro, North Carolina airport to await a future operator. That new operator became Monarch Airlines. They took delivery of this aircraft in early 1996. The plane was repainted with a yellow and black cheat line along the fuselage and with the company logo emblazoned on the tail. The aircraft was re-registered as the aforementioned Golf-Delta Mike Charlie Alpha. The aircraft would remain in service with Monarch Airlines until late 2001. This airliner wasn't just an aircraft. It was a vessel of adventure that took passengers to incredible destinations around the world. From London to exotic locations like the Caribbean, Africa, and Asia, this aircraft connected people across continents. From its innovative cockpit design to its efficient engines, this aircraft pushed the boundaries of aviation technology. As all good things must come to an end, so did the operational life of this airliner. With changing industry dynamics, Monarch Airlines eventually retired this remarkable aircraft. However, its legacy lives on in the hearts of aviation enthusiasts and in the annals of aviation history. It's heartwarming to see how aviation enthusiasts continue to pay tribute to this airplane. This airplane, after retirement and scrapping, has become a museum piece while it's on display at the Manchester Airport Aviation Viewing Park just off the Manchester Airport grounds. And there you have it, the captivating journey through Monarch Airlines McDonnell Douglas DC-10-30, registered as Golf-Delta Mike Charlie Alpha. From its groundbreaking features to the incredible memories it created, this aircraft holds a special place in aviation history. Thank you for joining me today. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more fascinating aviation content. Until next time, blue skies and happy landings. The video on the screen now is a 1-400 scale model produced by a company called Gemini Jets in 2004. This particular model, as seen here, is one of two produced over the years by Gemini Jets in 1-400 and in-flight models in 1-200 scale. Along with this, there are three of this aircraft in a Zambia Airways guise, with two in 1-200 scale aircraft from in-flight models and one in 1-400 scale model aircraft from Aero Classics. For any enterprise that is interested, this channel is available for advertising for your company. This opportunity is available for all reputable North American companies. Please contact me at the shown email address for details. This channel survives with you, the viewer, and your ongoing support. The more you watch my videos from start to finish helps me get a larger distribution, which will bring in more subscribers that will then repeat this process. If you like what you've seen, hit those like buttons and spread the word. We've enjoyed making this video, and we hope you've had fun watching it. Thank you, and good day.